Hello my dear students and friends, welcome back to my session on Arduino in 21 days. We are on day 16. Since I'm not having more kits for executing more and more programs, I'll be explaining some simple programs only this time. So this last yesterday also we saw about the single analog input, multiple digital output. We used 7 LEDs. Here we will be using 11 LEDs. That is one difference. The other difference in the program is if you raise this the variable potentiometer or variable resistor, if you increase it, the LED starting from LED 1, 2, 3 up to 11, it will glow one after the other. It will go permanently. That is, if you increase the volume from 0 to 1, LED 1 will glow. From 1 to 2 maybe, both LED 1 and LED 2 will be glowing. Again LED 1, 2, 3 will be glowing, like that. If you raise it to full volume, or if you turn it clockwise fully, all 11 LEDs will be glowing. So that is the program. That is the program. It's a very simple program only. So since I don't have any more kits because of the lockdown, I am not able to purchase any thing. So in the difference, that is the second difference. Once again I repeat, the first difference is multiple output, but instead of 7 yesterday, today I use 11. I am using 11 LEDs, right? D2 to D12. Generally I am not using D0 and D1. We can use it, no problem. Generally the D0 and D1 pin, it is, now I'll show you my first, this is the nano D0. This is D0. It works as RX also. There is a transmitting and receiving the signal. It acts as RxD, this acts as TxD, but we can use it, no problem. But I haven't used. I used only from D2 to D12 only. I didn't use D0 and D1. D13 also I am not using, because this is also connected with the LED in the board itself. That LED also will be blinking, so there won't be any any negative remark when it comes to the functionality of the program. Okay, but to be on safe side, we can use 11 LED, we can use 11 LEDs maximum, because it has 11 IO channels. But the D0, D1 and D13 I am not using, so 11 LEDs I am using it in this particular program. You can try for all 14 LEDs also here instead of 11. Okay, it will work. It will work. That is the thing. So this is the program. So LED 1 to 11. LED 1 is assigned with the D2 in the Arduino. LED 11 is assigned to D12, right? And this is the servo pin configurations, right? So these are the 11 IOs. I am using it as outputs only. There is no input, but input is the analog A0, right? Then the third difference here is, previously I used, I mapped the 2024 divisions to 10 values, 10 divisions, but I am mapping it to 14 divisions here. There is another difference here. So again, the next difference is, in the previous case I used 2 equal symbol. That is, if map value is exactly equal to 3, at that particular place alone the LED 2, maybe LED 1 or LED 2, whatever be, will be glowing. On all other occasions it will be low, but in this particular case, if it is greater than or equal to 0, okay, after the mapped value reaches 3 and it is moving beyond, in those region, in those occasions, the LED will be high, on the high state. So that is another point actually. That is another point. Okay, see, like that you try to do some small changes. You can play with some small changes, so then you will understand the more about the programming. Okay, it's a very simple program, so not much explanation is needed from my side. Again, I will not be showing the how I fused and how I tested, and I am not showing my video. Actually, I didn't take it also because it is quite explanatory, right? Self-explanatory. You can try. While trying, you may face some problem, but try to sort out the problem by yourself. Then only you will have a strong foundation, I could say. See, there is a single do to achieve this particular task, but there are many don'ts. You should know some don'ts also, the wrong ways also you should know, because a 11 month baby, before standing and walking, it will fall down at least more than 50-60 times. But after falling down only, the baby has to stand up and it starts walking, something like that. Okay, so you may face some problem. See, what is the it will tell, this will tell about what the problem is. So read that error message, based on it you try yourself to correct the problem. So these are the ways, that is the way to correct the problem. Okay, you can have some more thing also, that is there is one more thing, I'll give it in comment here. An exclamatory mark, you have this kind of thing, status equal to I status. You can invert whenever LED 1 is on, LED is on means LED 2 must be off, and vice versa. So for that you can use the exclamatory symbol, that is a inverse symbol actually. Okay, so you can try those things also. Like that, do more experiment, then only you are able to understand the concepts. Okay, so that's it for the day 16, you know. Yes, day 16, same problem with the yesterday, same as the yesterday's problem. Instead of 7 LEDs, 11 LEDs here, and mapping is concerned, instead of 14 it is 20 now, or it is instead of 10 it is 14 now. Okay, and instead of equal, it is greater than or equal I used. So these are the changes I made in this particular program. Otherwise all are one. Again, the 8th, 9th, 10th I added. Previously we had only 7 LEDs, right? The 8, 9, 10, 11 I added. So that's it. Okay, so tomorrow we see some more thing on maybe tomorrow. Definitely I'll show you how to use the, how to control a bigger stepper motor through the Arduino, right? So luckily I have one big stepper motor and the controller for it. So tonight I'll be assembling all these things. Tomorrow I'll be preparing the video for that actually. Okay, so those haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel. Then inform this to other students and friends and faculty members, so then they'll also gain some information through my sessions actually, right? Thank you so much.